was really clear on. He says that the four questions were a lifesaver for us. They were a lifesaver for us as we started this work. He said, but I always wanted to be more than just studying my curriculum week after week, right? A unit by unit, week after week. We need to talk about those things that we also see a value in our students, and how can we rebuild hope in kids who might have lost hope for their own learning. So when a team is doing that, they're doing the work of question number one at a really higher level than I think some people see it as. While we talk about identifying the learning outcomes we want in every unit, the original work of this said, what knowledge, question number one, what knowledge, skills, and dispositions must students learn to be successful at the next level? So the concept that we explore then is, what is a disposition? Well, the dictionary describes it as a person's inherent qualities of mind and character. The thesaurus would put it as an inclination, a tendency, a proneness, propensity for, proclivity to. So when we think about what we want from our students, don't we want them to take ownership of their own learning, to be engaged in that? And I know that as we do that, they will see themselves where they are in their learning, and they get a chance when we orchestrate and direct and choreograph it well, they'll see a chance to think about, so here's where I am now. Am I satisfied with that? And if I want to grow to this next level, here's what I need to grow to this next level. And if I am at this level and I'm happy with that level and it is at the level of expectation for success, then what is it that I'm doing that I need to keep doing in order to remain successful in school? All that is part of something that we can have a direct impact if we think this thing through. And I know we have opportunities that we just miss every now and then. We just miss them, right? Because we don't think about them from the perspective of having kids track and study their own progress. As an example, I know that every school does something with grades. They report those grades out on a periodic basis, at least every 9 weeks or every trimester, but almost every school that I know of has progress reports, midterm progress reports that the teachers provide to the students. And my thought is this, when you're doing that, and I've seen it on a frequent enough basis that it's every week with some students, when you're doing that, do you see that as something you do out of compliance and to send home a report or make it available on the internet to parents? Or do you see it as a way to be more engaged with the students, to have them calculate their own grades, to have them look at the learning outcomes that they've mastered and the ones that they have not yet reached proficiency on? If we could take that whole grade reporting process and have kids become more interactive with that, it would be an absolutely win in terms of their ownership. One of the schools that is a model PLC school, Fern Creek High School in Louisville, Kentucky. One of the things that they do is every 6 weeks, they have their students stop and calculate their own grades. And one of the things that they said is having kids do that gave us greater ownership from our students. It wasn't something we just reported out of compliance, out of the routine of our processes in education, but instead became more of a thought about how do we get kids to see where they are in their learning and not leave it up to parents to orchestrate the conversations, because some parents don't know what to say or what's provided or what opportunities a child has in order to grow. So leaving it in the hands of parents is never our best strategy. Leaving it in the hands of educators who have the capability to know how to direct a student's thinking, how to provide the right kind of feedback to continue, have them continue growing, how to identify the steps they can take and how you can be a part of that. That's just so critical in this process of seeing and taking ownership and being motivated by your own ownership of your learning.